Good morning, students. Welcome to digital class. Students, today we shall study subject EVS, class 3. And the topic today I am going to discuss and tell you is our food. Students, in the previous class we have studied about the food. We saw various types of food like energy giving food, body building food, protective food. All these things we have already studied. Today we shall study the methods of cooking. So let us first we must know the food items which are eaten raw and some of the food items are eaten after cooking. So most fruits are eaten raw. Generally fruits are eaten raw, we know. But there are some vegetables which can be eaten raw, like cucumber, tomato, cabbage, carrots and radish, etc. These are the vegetables we eat them as a, we say it as a salad. So these can be eaten raw, we can cook also. The food which are cooked before eating are like grains, pulses, fish, meat and vegetables like potato, cauliflower and beans, etc. These are the food materials we cannot eat them as raw. We have to cook before eating them. And in the next week when we move, see the what is the benefit of cooking. Cooking kills germs and makes food soft and easy to digest. This is what we know. Whenever we have to drink the water, first we have to boil the water and drink. This is what we are suggesting. The same way, food item also, if there is any harmful germs, when we cook, it is heated and due to the heat, the germs dies. And that is good for our health. Okay. So this is what we sow, which we can eat raw and which we can eat after cooking. Now let us come to the different methods of cooking. Now we will see there are some points, the methods of cooking. So first point is frying method. Frying method is of cooking raw food to enhance flavor, submerging them in the oil. So we know the frying method. This type of method needs more oil to fry the food materials. Here I will give you some examples like puri, samosa, bhujia, etc. You already know these are the things they are fried in the oil. So this is what we see in the first method. Now we will move to the second, that is boiling. Boiling is the method of cooking food in boiling water. We know, we eat, all of us, we eat the rice. How it is cooked? Rice is cooked in the water. First the water is boiled and then rice is cooked there. And this is the way our food is ready. So there are some examples like boiled rice, tea, coffee. These are the examples. We boil them and then we use them as our diet. Now, the third point we see, steaming. Is the method of cooking food over boiling water. We cannot put direct in the water, but first we have to get heat the water and example, we see idli, dobla, puttu, etc. This is what we see, and we all of us know idli how it is cooked. So this is the method of steaming. Now the fourth point we see, that is baking method. In this method, food cooked in a oven at high temperature. For example, like biscuits, bread, and cakes. So in this method, the oven is kept, and under the oven with the charcoal or wood, fire is put there, and oven gets heat, and on the oven the food materials are kept in a high temperature. So such type of foods are like biscuits and breads and cakes which we eat. These foods are baked in a oven, cooked in the high temperature. Now fifth point, roasting method. In the roasting method, food is cooked over and open. Flame or using drying in an oven. See, this is also a kind of roasting food. First the fire is lit, and this type of food are not cooked in the burning fire but in the high temperature of flame of wood or charcoal. So see, here we see the food is cooked over an open flame. So upon the fire, the food items are kept, and food items get heated with the flame, and it get roasted, and that food gets ready to eat. So these are the methods of cooking. Students, now I told you the food materials which can be eaten raw and which can be cooked before eating, and what is the benefit of cooking, and then slowly we came the methods of cooking, and here we saw five methods of cooking. I'm sure that you might have understood the things which I wanted to tell you. So today I end my class, students, here. Okay, bye.